It's going to be Matilda instead that has been left wide open since the beginning of time, at the very least. Now, they have guaranteed ways to at least knock Oh My Venus out of the real world manipulation.
Oh my god, the draft has been set by both of the teams right now. Give us your predictions, man. Let us know in the chat right now. Is it going to be Blacklist International or BTK?
Gonna be a normal draft for game number 5, and I love it. They're gonna be sticking to what works. The classic Aljus Alice coming up from Blacklist International. Greedy, but still very strong.
Oh, this is it. This is for all marbles here. Is North America gonna make the biggest statement here at N3 by knocking Blacklist down to the lower bracket, or is it gonna be Blacklist taking this game? Only one may survive. Blacklist on the blue side, BTK on the red. Let's hop into the land of dawn.
There's only one phrase to sum it all up. Boom, bang, bada bing. Are y'all ready for game 5?
I'm so ready for game 5 here. And immediately, we have to identify how these lanes are going to go. Thamus is going to get punished here on that top side by Shark instantaneously as Matilda controlling that river pressure.
I want to say the Thams is more inclined to win against the Esmeralda in a 1v1 setup. That's why BTK put Shark in there just to poke out this Esmeralda, this Thams for a little bit. Maybe that will give a little bit of a head start for BTK.
Absolutely. Now, again, it is going to be really, really good for the side of Blacklist here in the early stages with Wise just basically getting that little wander, right? Both of the junglers need to scale. And this is what BTK needs to do with the composition, is to get an initial lead, I suppose, with that Yisun Shin. You need to get that guy rolling, man. Once he gets those items, he is going to be a nuisance. But if he scales as well as the Aldous, honestly, I my favorite Aldous.
Yeah.
And one thing I do like about Blacklist International, this Ruby Eve combination. I love this because you always set up for the real world manipulation. And as a position 5 Ruby, you're just required to just dish out the crowd control and not much about the damage, and have the damage department be covered by the Eve. So it makes total sense to me, especially because what Blacklist International wants to do is just to drag out the game long enough for both the stacking or infinitely scaling heroes like the Aldous and the Alice will be strong in the late game.
Yeah, I mean, this is the most standard metagame we've seen from either one of these sides. Very familiar, especially to the NPL regions, who overall generally hover around a lot of these heroes here. Now, BTK immediately moving in towards that topside jungle. So far, the level 4s are getting hit by both junglers at this point of time. Turtle's coming up in about 5 seconds or so. Now, rather slow, but Oh My Venus now getting punished here. MOBA Zayn getting very close to getting some good damage, and maybe even first blood.
Honestly, that was really good setup for the side of BTK. They go in for the trade. You can see, actually, that was really well coordinated. Yep. They were going for the camp in that, jungle invading as well, but they know that they want to go for a fight in the mid lane. They want to deal additional damage, and that literally just set up for
Red
the turtle.
What's happening bot side here? The turtle goes over by the STB here for BTK, but so far, Firechecking getting a good Chaos Assault on towards Wise's side, but he can just absorb the damage. Yeah. Both heroes don't have a lot of items in or a lot of stacks, but the Chase Fate coming up towards that side, just to speed up his clearing.
Yeah. I really like how Wise using this Aldous. He's really good. He's using that ultimate very efficiently, just to roam around the map to get him to places a little bit faster, but look at this, BTK going in for the gank.
It's not going to be good just yet. Oh, they forced out the flicker coming in from Ohab. This could be a potential punish later on in towards that game. He's got to wait 120 seconds before he gets that back, but let's double check on the items so far.
Yeah, for BTK, they're going to be amassing a lot of items, which is good because, you know, at least this time they're evening up when it comes to trades.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Zio's going to lose 50% of his HP for and now. Nothing much is being achieved here for either side. It's a dead even game thus far.
That really is surprising because we know that in the first 4 games of the match, they just run into each other like so often. But this time, it's game number 5. Everything is literally on the line. The winner will advance to the upper bracket, and the loser will be put in that lower bracket where there's so many strong teams that can eliminate you. So everything hangs in the balance in this last game.
Honestly, this is the calm before the storm, right? You know something's bound to happen, and that is going to be most probably the second turtle of the game, you know? Most of the time here, after the first turtle, none of the teams want to go for any crazy engages, but wait a minute, I might just made a mistake, Venus!
He's on some trouble here. He's taking way too much damage here, and Shark immediately able to punish first blood by Razor going over to BTK. Really nicely done.
That was beautiful. beautiful again.
Mm-hmm. And then Zia even held on to the real world manipulation. Oh, sorry, in the meta. There's like, because he knows that they want to control this turtle area after the fight. So BTK really managing their resources well.
Look, BTK, they're looking so warmed up right now. They're working like a well-oiled machine. You can definitely see that they're, you know, stuttering here and there during the earlier stages of the game against Blacklist International. But I feel like they've really found their own momentum and really oiled up the gears.
Absolutely, man. The thing is, for the side of BTK, they're just really good at these prolonged fights, and that's exactly what they want to keep on doing. Just look for these crazy skirmishes on all across the board, and this is most probably what they're baiting in to do right here.
Mm-hmm. Yep, Wise, he's going to have to get on out of there. I don't think he has enough sex for the real world manipulation. Ooh. Yes, there they have it. Fly Chicken finds it again. Solo killing Oheb, and now the bottom side is getting initially pushed down as BTK wants to press the advantage here. Nicely done by Fry Chicken.
Like I said, it's all a setup for a fight. They only started the turtle to look for a fight in Blacklist International. They went a little bit too greedy. They didn't have a good position there. They didn't even know whether the bottom side was winning, was pushing, and they still forced it away. These are mistakes that are uncanny.
Very uncanny. I mean, Oheb, he has played this matchup way many times before in many other players' matchups in the Philippines, but for some reason, Fry Chicken finds the opening kill against Oheb. That's a solo kill, in fact. And that gave BTK so much control into that turtle. Even Edward was too late to the party, and BTK just got that objective, which is what they needed. If you want to play the Yi Sin Chin from the jungle role, you have to always get the objectives. First turtle, second turtle, and the third turtle.
Mm-hmm. Here comes BTK as they rotate from the top side down towards Oheb, and they know for a fact that turret is so low. And there we go. Mobazane just going to tank a couple of shots just to break down the turret here on bottom side and open the map up a little bit more.
That's the play you do when you have the turtle buff. Take advantage of the shield. That shield cools down, okay? So you have to make the most of it. And he did exactly that.
Very smart, very intelligent plays here coming in from the side of BTK, not only getting the turret in the bottom side, but also rotating their members to that top side to just protect the turret. So not only, again, are they looking for the proactive movements on the map to get objectives, but they're also defending their objectives really, really well.
Mm-hmm. Yep, I think the game's only really going to start taking place once mid opens up, but we'll see how this is going to play as BTK now starting to press their advantages here. A very slight advantage, 2.2k so far in towards Blacklist's jungle. Slowly but surely, they just have to push and pull until somebody makes that mistake. Feather Airstrike does come up. Haji isn't going to force any situation right now. His top side might be in a little bit of trouble. Majority of the BTK members just hovering for priority over this turtle.
Well, Blacklist International is giving Oheb the double lane treatment, wherein you also get the mid lane, some of the mid lane minions, as well as your own lane, the gold lane minions, in fact, for this Alice. This is because you need recovery. And maybe for the next purple buff, they are going to give it to the Alice so that at least they can fight in this turtle. However, they might be too late.
Oh, man, they're just so clean with these engages, with these setups.
Wait,
look at the
top side. Top side, Edward, he might be in some trouble here as Victor has already initiated on top of him. Fire Chicken came in a little later. To disregard what Edward had to make in terms of his statement. But so far, BTK and as well as Blacklist International, BTK is posing questions and Blacklist International hasn't necessarily put up answers just yet. They're just avoiding these questions.
The switch has been flipped. Blacklist International identifying that BTK have already gotten a good early game. They will now split the map. It's macro play from now on. You're going to see Wise just going into some parts of the lane and maybe clear that one out. Edward in a static lane, all the while Oheb just controlling all of the mid lane as well as maybe some other lane. So the thing is, Blacklist International is all full macro mode at this point. What will BTK do with this, though?
They're matching them. Look, Esmeralda is dealing with Aldis down on towards that bottom side. And, you know, she can, for now, she can handle him while there is still time. But BTK want to press their advantage with Fly Chicken as they move on forward. Shark does not start the initiation just yet, but definitely baits Edward into potentially using something or at the very least popping his ult early. Oh, Shark now getting pulled in by the I'm Offended, who gets out very easily. Feathered Airstrike. I can guarantee that they're not going to get punished here. Oheb throwing the flowing butt, hopefully tried to deter them away.
The thing about Blacklist composition is that they really do want to go for that wombo combo team fight. If they don't get that, it's going to be actually really, really hard. And that's the thing with the Yi Sun Shin. It's really good. Not only do you have that unstoppable dash, but you also have another option. Yeah. You can take that guiding win.
Yeah, the thing with Blacklist International is they went for the Aldous and the Alice, and this is as greedy as it sounds, right? Everybody needs those stacks. So in both Oheb as well as Wise, they have that passive component wherein they need time, they need gold and XP. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, Feather Airstrike already coming out. As MOBA Zane gets targeted. Wow. The chain fade does not work. I'm offended comes on through, but here it comes. Real wall manipulation. And Oheb's doing a great job at cutting the members down of BTK. It's a 2-for-1 trade so far, but now Victor all by himself. Edward is coming in to say hello to the situation as Oh My Venus manages to get on out of there with a quick flicker. But look, Fried Chicken on that top side. You may have one extra kill, but I got another turret right under their noses.
What happened?
Hold up! Victor manages to pick off Oh My Venus down on the bottom side of the map. Now they have a very clear advantage. Edward holding on strong as Fly Chicken can easily win this, but he has to time it well. Flickers out of the situation as Edward already using the Molten Slice and as a vengeance at the same time. Oh, MOBA Zane covers everybody, dropping down his ult, the Mountain Shocker, to give them vision.
All right, again, I want to emphasize this. Blacklist International, their composition relies heavily on the full 5v5 combo wombos. And as you can see, sure, they got the initial victory in that team fight, but it's all for naught. Oheb,
he's dead.
What?
He's dead. He went right into the chopping block, and BTK happily dropped the guillotine.
Oh my God.
Very, very unlikely jump coming out from Oheb. What was he hoping to achieve there? I mean, doesn't have the best way to steal the Lord. And in fact, the Lord just, you know, the announcer just announced that the Lord has been taken. And maybe we get to see that in the replay. All due fairness, Blacklist International, they're really off of what Mirko was trying to say, the wombo combos. You can see Haji, the Kevin Durant, the KDA machine setting up for this play with the Ruby as well as the Eve combo that we have always been talking about. But off-cam kills is what we saw. I mean, what we didn't see. Mm-hmm. I mean, kill onto the Eve.
But let's see this momentum here coming out for BTK. You can see they're getting hungrier. They're getting thirstier. Oh, you know what they want. The Lord has already been achieved. And here comes the Falling Star Moon on towards Y side. They've taken all the tier 2 turrets. And with the next wave, mid tier 2 shall fall. And Blacklist International forced back a 6k goal lead for BTK. Is this huge or what? As Haji goes into the middle of the fight, Victor is able to hold on strong. Feathered airstrike.
Damage.
Falling Star Moon to secure the kill. He trades his life, but he doesn't care about it anymore as they will open up the inhibitors here. BTK open up the top side already. Blacklist International running out of time.
Oh, crazy as it sounds. BTK just off of their confidence in that play. I mean, Victor, he knows that the rest of his team can just take a better trade. For example, yes, they did die on their Expedite in exchange for a Ruby, but they were able to get a kill, a turret down up top. So this is BTK getting an inhibitor 11 minutes into this game.
These are the things that Blacklist does to other teams, and BTK, they're doing it to them. What is going on, man? M3 has literally been just flipped over its head, and we are seeing that BTK again. I want to emphasize this one more time. No coach, no analyst, no problem.
In every world championship, there's always the underdog that we'd love to see thrive. Mm-hmm. BTK might be it.
Yep, BTK just might be it. Edward going into the middle fight, absorbing that damage. Chain fade on towards Wombos. And he manages to get out of the real one. Manipulation does not clip it right at the end.
What?
The fight did. That's Victor. Fight Chicken Victor has done it. Victor is now in the back line as they find a huge opportunity to break for it. They flicker on for it. They find another kill. That's two. They can get the third. Wombos Zane. They have done it. They have gotten that triple kill. No wave to punish as BTK move towards that top side. They're gonna proxy the waves. They just need Shark to destroy Oheb here. Oh. Well done. They have done it. The biggest upset here so far. BTK have beaten Blacklist International. GG. Well played. North America has come.
What the heck happened there, man? Your all-nighter has just been... Oh my, I'm just speechless right now. BTK, baby! Everyone in this team, they came over. The first time they've met was in the airport, and they managed to get the victory against the tournament favorites.
That is huge.
Oh my goodness, and Victor! As well as MOBA saying, they're so happy with this. The odds are way against them. The 2% that went and, you know, voted for BTK from the Philippines, they're so happy with this. The majority of the regions, if you look at the other countries, they didn't vote as much for BTK, but BTK defied all odds. No coaches, no managers, I'm sorry if I repeat a miracle, but that is a massive, massive victory for BTK.
I don't know. The sighs of relief of the BTK members well deserved as they move on towards the next stage here in the upper brackets, and they hold strong throughout. So happy for this team. And